What's going on, everyone? This is Steve Place from Investing with Options, and today we're going to take a look at Facebook. Now, Facebook was really interesting over the past few months because it did not participate with the NASDAQ rally at the beginning of the year, and it did not really participate with the NASDAQ sell-off into February. This has led to a potential compression breakout where we expect volatility to expand soon. Now, one indicator you can use to observe volatility compression and expansion is a squeeze indicator. What we're focusing on here are the green dots versus the red dots. Now, the way this indicator works is that there are two volatility envelopes that you look at. The first is the Bollinger Band, and then the second is a Keltner channel. And the way that they're calculated is slightly different from one another, but basically what happens is when the Bollinger Band goes inside the Keltner channel, it indicates that there has been non-reverting volatility. So we haven't seen a strong trend in either direction, and we've also seen volatility compression. Okay, so this is a weekly chart, and for Facebook to have a squeeze going on this long, so volatility compression going on for 2.5 months, without any kind of volatility expansion is statistically significant. The last time we saw one this long was back here, and then it triggered. We saw a strong run, big gap down on earnings, okay? So this indicator doesn't necessarily mean that we're going to see strong expansion in the context of the trend, but it's a generally good idea here. What the other thing I want to point out is that the implied volatility, so the supply and demand for Facebook options, all things considered, is pretty low right here. 30-day implied volatility is sitting at 20%. That's pretty low relative to what we've seen. Now, the trade we're going to look at is going to have a higher implied volatility, and that's going to be because it has event risk pricing in it. All right, so there's a couple things. The first is the date of the earnings that's coming up, and the second is how Facebook traded relative to what we saw in the NASDAQ 100 index. So the first thing to keep in mind is the next earnings date is at the beginning of May. So May 2nd, 2018, which means if you go and you look at May options, the implied volatility, so the option premiums, are going to be a little higher, and they're going to stay elevated. They're going to stay up as we head into that earnings event. Okay, so this is one where it probably makes sense to be bullish volatility, not just in the options, but also in the price of the stock. Let's go ahead and drill down to a daily chart. And I want to point out a few things. So just consider this December range that got knocked out right here. And that was supposed to be a rectangle, but it didn't happen. Let's try that. There we go. Okay. And think about the price movement that we saw in Facebook, right? So a small move above that December range, followed by a gap down, followed by a little bit more of a push to the upside, and then a retest of these November lows right here, okay? I want you to contrast that with, let's just look at the Qs, all right? And think about that same December range, and there was a much larger move, a much harder melt up, and a much, much stronger sell-off in the Qs relative to Facebook. So normally what happens is that the indexes, all right, so the S&P and the NASDAQ and the Russell and the Dow, have lower volatility. They don't move as much as individual stocks. And when they, and then stocks will move larger because they are slightly riskier. But this is one time in which we saw Facebook not really move that much in either direction. Okay, now a couple different things to look at right here. We also had, you know, if you want to look at a daily squeeze indicator, we did see this trigger just a couple days ago, and it tends to resolve in the context of the trend, and it tends to resolve in the context of the momentum that we've seen. So it's a bullish indicator. We did see a test of this 170 level, and that was a failed breakdown. when we see failed breakdowns, we tend to see the stock run to the upper end of the range, which is right around $190 a share. Now, there's one more thing that you want to look out for right here, and that is this head and shoulders pattern. And I don't use a whole lot of classical technical analysis unless I'm looking for pattern failures, right? So we had the start of this, okay? And if you look at the textbook technical analysis patterns, this should have, quote unquote, should have run to 170, broken down underneath 170, and then we see a strong move to the downside. The technical pattern was truncated and the pattern failed by making a new higher high right here. Now, it wasn't a huge higher high, but it was a higher high enough. What I'm expecting here is, given the fact that we did not see a whole lot of volatility in Facebook over the past few months, right? There was a decent amount off of this earnings event, but we didn't see that same kind of melt up, right? If you're dealing with, you know, an index that looks like this, and then you see this melt up and then a big drop and then a rally again, there's going to be a lot of this overhead supply to deal with. And so if the stock runs into that overhead supply, sometimes it finds sellers coming in, right? If Facebook comes into this 190 level and starts to hold right here, buyers will be in control and we'll see a strong move. All right, so I'm pretty bullish on Facebook. And there's a couple different ways you can play it. You can look at out of the money put calendars, you can look at put spread sales, but given the fact that we know that implied volatility is pretty cheap, you know, 30-day implied volatility sitting at 20%. That's pretty low relative to the range that it's used to seeing. All right, so options are fairly cheap. This is one where I think it makes sense to look at just some straight up long calls. This is what I call a convexity bet, where it's a lower odds trade, yet the payout on your wins should be much, much higher than your losses. So you can have more losses than wins, but if your win payout is 3-1, 4-1, 5-1, then you can accept a slightly lower odds. Now, a lot of traders are skittish or scared about, you know, when you look at long calls and, you know, that's your P&L right now, you're worried about that time decay. Remember, if you look at May options, if you go out to May, the time decay risk, okay, the premium in related to time will be replaced by the premium related to the event. So they'll actually stay bid going into that earnings event. You don't have to worry that much. You know, even if Facebook trades sideways for a month, you're not going to lose as much as you think because the implied volatility is gonna stay bid and the option premiums are gonna stay bid. So the trade I like right here is the May 195 call, and it's currently going for about $4.70, all right? So basically buying anything under $5. The reason I like 195 is that it coincides with this main price level. When we see a failed breakdown, we tend to rally to the other end of the range, which we have 190 and 195. Now, this is such an obvious price level that many times this will act, and that's my magnet, okay? That obvious resistance level will often act as a magnet. So price will auction into that level just to see if those sellers are going to come back in. Now, what happens here, let's just say we get to 190 and the stock isn't fiercely rejected lower, instead it trades sideways and we see evidence of acceptance, price acceptance by the buyers. $200, which is a nice round number, will also act as a little magnet. Okay, so your max risk on this trade is $470 per contract. And here's the thing, if Facebook rolls over and it loses 170 and it breaks down, you know, your risk is fixed at $4.70. A fast move to 190 is going to be a payout of about $230 per spread or per contract. All right, so you're looking at about a 50% risk. Into that 190, 195 area is going to be a good place to take off a little bit of risk or convert this trade to a spread. Now, if we do manage to see a convexity move, then this trade, okay, the value of this trade will be plus $700. Okay, so $700 per spread at about $200 per share. All right, now May is, you know, it's about, what, 2 months out? So you're paying about $5 to have 2 months of potential upside exposure. Your options expiration break even is going to be 195. This is one of those where if the stock is headed into earnings and you've got, you know, let's just say the stock rallies into earnings into 195, it's a good time to take a little bit of risk off, but you want to try and hold it through earnings, right? Because if the stock is rallying in anticipation of that earnings event, you want to be able to catch a little bit of an earnings surprise. And given the fact that Facebook has done nothing for 6 months, has gone sideways for 6 months, any kind of significant volatility expansion will be very large, right? Think about this range, right? Lower end of the range, 170, higher end of the range, 190, that's 20 points. You add 20 onto 190, that's gonna be 210 for a potential longer term target. All right, so it's one of those where it's a lower odds trade, all right? So you may not expect to win, let's just say, more than 40% on these trades, all right? So if you have a 40% win rate, you wanna earn ideally something like a 3-to-1 payout to help justify the positive expectancy. And given the fact that we've had volatility compression, sideways action for 6 months, given the fact that the stock is near all-time highs, given the fact that we've got two magnet levels at 195 and 200, given the fact that earnings will help to buffer any kind of time decay risk and implied volatility as a whole is fairly low right now, then this is going to be a pretty good risk-reward trade. Now you may ask, well, do you want to put some stops in? And I would rather take smaller size on the calls and go full risk than try and manage any kind of stop. You know, if you go on a ton of size right here, you know, at 185, and then you say, okay, I'm gonna be smart and set my stop underneath this recent swing low, and then Facebook sells off and then bounces again, you know, you're gonna look kind of silly. The whole reason options exist is to limit your risk. The option premium is low enough to justify just buying these options. Now, if you wanna limit your risk even more, then what you can do is what's known as a bull call spread. And I would look at the 195, 205 bull call spread. So the May 195 call is currently going for $4.80. And then the 205 call is currently going for $2.16. That puts your maximum risk at 264. And well, I guess I rounded up to 265. And it puts your maximum payout at 735. All right, so if you want to do the math really quick, 735 on 265 is going to be 277%. So it's almost a 3-to-1 trade just based off that structure. All right, so if you can pull 3-to-1 and you're looking at a implied odds of, you know, greater than 30%, then this is going to be a pretty good trade. All right, so that's what I'm looking at right here. I'm bullish momentum. I'm bullish on the stock right now. I think options are cheap enough to just go out and buy them, look for a convexity trade. Ideally, we get a fast move to 200 into earnings, and then, you know, we'll see if we get some kind of a crazy earnings beat, and then the tech stock just goes on an absolute momentum tear. That's the ideal case right here. If you like these videos, check out my blog, Investing with Options. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel. Have a great day.